Woke up with my toolie, what it do? Meet me in the alley with the troops. I got red shooters, I got blue. Let that thing down and point at you.
So, sorry, you're with my giraffe, my koala. I have to get ready for a little thing later. I think it would be time to take a shower. Because, look at me. I'm going to take you guys on that journey that I do every single day. It'd be such a weird thing. Like, why post a shower with me? Like, why? I mean, we all shower, but wondering what I do for my skin, and I have to shower, so I was like, might as well do them both. So let's go to the shower. Welcome to my bathroom. I actually have my ring light in here. Wow, this is wild. Oh, let me get the products, and then we're gonna get it going. So regarding my face, this is what I've been using since like sixth grade. I've never had like a lot of flare-ups with my skin, so this does great things. I just got this. This is called Burt's Bees Renewal Refining Cleanser. I use this sometimes, maybe mostly when I have makeup on, depends on the day. And then I use this Lush Ocean Salt face and body scrub. I don't really use it on my face because, you know, face is kind of sensitive, kind of dry. Using like a really intense Lush scrub that can go in the body on my face would not go very well. So here's the razor I use. This is called Gillette Venus, whatever. And then I use their shower shave cream to get those legs smooth. I don't think I'm gonna shave my legs today, but there you go. The shampoo and conditioners I use in the shower, coconut milk nourishing OGX. You already know. You can get these at Walmart, Target, wherever.
Bilger says it, this exclusive blend with coconut milk, coconut oil, and ultra whipped egg white protein.
Now, body wash. This is the one I'm using currently. I actually have like four body washes right now. I have two in my room. So this is the one I've been using recently. There's literally body wash on it, ew. The Brazilian Glam, Brazil Nut Oil, and Maracuja Tone Body Wash. This smells so good. I really recommend you guys go get it. And also have this one in my shower. It's Caress Daily Silk. This one really doesn't smell like much. It smells more like just like bar soap, so. I might give this one to my sister, but I don't know. I have two more body washes in my room, so whenever I get done with this one, we'll get into those. There's actually my all-time favorite. This is called Caress Tahitian Renewal. This is my favorite body wash, but obviously sister is running out, so here are exfoliating gloves. They're really, really ugly, but I use exfoliating gloves on my body like once every couple weeks, you know, depends, maybe once a week. The loofah I use, normally it depends, sometimes I use a hand cloth, sometimes I use a loofah. So once I hop up in the shower, I normally sit there, rinse all of the dirt off, just rinse my body. Then I always wash my hair first, because that's what you should always do, because what's the point of cleaning your body first and then washing your hair? Because when you wash your hair, all that dirt goes onto your body. Normally, I clean my face first, then I wash my hair, then I clean my body, and then I do all that extra shit. So here we go. I might be giving some tips through, but let's get this shit going. Let's get in the shower. Let's have some fun. I know a lot of people in these videos, they like wear like a bathing suit top, but I'm just gonna like show you guys my face because I need to clean my whole body today. So I don't wanna have like a bathing suit on. I'm gonna go grab my robe and a computer so I can play some tunes, play some bops while we're getting it going, because honestly, showering is one of my like favorite things to do in the world. I love, no, I don't like feeling dirty, but getting dirty, Yeah, being all dirty and then getting into the shower after like a long ass day of sweating and everything, completely rejuvenated. It's really a good one. It's really nice. Wanna be with the sun. Yeah, I don't want to get like a bunch of water on the ground, so I'm sorry about this. What else am I supposed to do? I don't know if people film these videos. So there's my face washed off. I'm gonna take this Burt's Bees one and I'm just gonna put it like where I have my acne, like right here. Yeah. I washed my face. Check. As you can see, it's really red. Shit happens, okay? Now I'm gonna use my conditioner. This is when I wash my face. This is when I wash my body. I'm gonna give a little heads up, okay? I'm gonna make a little tutorial if you smell like ass, okay? If you walk out the house and you let yourself smell like ass. Okay, here we go. What you need is a loofah, a hand towel, body wash, and courtesy, okay? That's all you need. Please. Okay, let's do this. If people at my school walk out the house thinking it's okay. Thinking it's okay to smell like that. So, what we're gonna do, especially if you're a guy, the same rule applies. Same rule applies. You take your loofah, you take your body wash. If things get tough, use your shampoo because I could care less. Just, I'm sick of smelling all of, I'm sick of it. So you take it and you see what I'm doing here. You see what I'm doing here. Lather it up in your hands.
Okay.
And you wash every crack or crevice down to your toenails. Okay. If you're a girl, you better wash around those boots. Okay. I'm just going to be like TMI. Under your armpits. Okay. In your ass crack. Please. If you do not clean your toilet paper is not enough, guys. So you need to clean everything. Okay? Your arms, okay? Your palms and your armpits. You need to clean everything. I take my razor, okay? And I shave my armpits. Do whatever you want. You don't have to shave your armpits, but that's just what I do. I shave my armpits like every day. Is this what I've come to? Shaving my armpits on the internet? Now we're almost done. We're almost ready for the world. Cleaning yourself is no joke, okay? Because if you don't smell good, even the aftercare showering, like, nobody's gonna wanna talk to you. So many opportunities are gonna be missed. So I'm gonna take this, okay? Ocean salt. And I normally take some like this. And I just like wash some of my body, like my thighs, you know what I'm saying? Especially like if I'm on my period, I use these all the time because like, when I'm on my period, I feel like I smell like trash 24/7. So that's basically my shower care. Cause your body is a temple and you need to be nice to her, okay? We love her. Be nice. Give her a good shower, okay? Cool. I just put my wet hair up because I didn't want to deal with it right now, but I do the least amount possible for my skin. I don't have enough energy, time, or money for that. So yeah, Aquaphor, my dude. Aquaphor or Vaseline. That is what I use on my face. I use another moisturizer, but this one I use over. I leave it on overnight. It's just what I do. And it leaves my skin so smooth, so glowy, and it just looks really natural, like it didn't even come from a product. I can't find my other moisturizer, so I'm just gonna use Aquaphor. It all depends on the day. Normally I just use this. I really touch my face a lot, which is not good, so maybe that's why I do have bad acne pop up sometimes. When I'm on my period, I get a bunch of chin acne and all that. But I've been doing this for like years and it's been fine. If you guys don't know, I live in Colorado. It's so dry here and it is very, very crucial for me to always have Aquaphor something on my face because it's just so bad outside. So I just put this on my face and it does the job. Because my face, I get really red easily, a little bit of rosacea. So I normally just like put a little bit of water on my face after I put them on before. And if I do get acne, I'm not a person, I don't pop pimples. I think that's disgusting. I don't try to make it go away. Cause when I do, it's just like, okay, whatever, it's a pimple, it's gonna be there. Having a pimple, people get pimples. Like, I'm not over here putting toothpaste on my face trying to make it go away. Clean and Clear face wash has been my day one forever. My last skincare routine, I used black soap, if you don't know, African black soap, and that actually cleared up my skin too, but it wasn't the organic one. I'm pretty sure I just used the not organic one. Me telling you my skincare routine probably won't do much because this is my skin. This is what works for my skin. I don't know what's gonna work for your skin, so I just say try things. Cause yeah, try to resist the urge, try not to touch your face, because literally in class I just go like this a lot because right here I get super dry and it just gets like flaky, but I need to stop doing that. For my body, after I take a shower, I just find a regular lotion, a random lotion. This isn't my favorite. My other Victoria's Secret lotion that I love is actually my backpack, but this is the Twisted Ivy Victoria's Secret lotion. This one kind of smells like hemp lotion, maybe a little bit. But I just take whatever lotion I have. It's very crucial for where I live to put on lotion 24/7. If you have crackly heels, is that a word? Put lotion on your feet, please. Socks after I put on lotion, because it just stays looking fresh. Soaks into the skin. Like I said, common courtesy. We're not trying to see nobody's ashiness, okay? Black soap I used a couple years ago. Is there hair on it? I don't know. No, not a couple years ago. Maybe last year? Not too long ago. face masks, I don't do that on an often thing. It's mainly because I just don't own a face mask. I used to just use my sister's, but obviously she's moved, so like I don't have any. So I'm gonna buy some off of Amazon soon. My favorites are the picture, they're called Freeman's. Those are super nice. And also this Victoria's Secret one I used the first day of school. My sister is gonna bring that to me because she actually doesn't use it. And she was like, well, if you want it. And I was like, it's really cooling and amazing. My favorite face masks are cooling, period. I don't do anything else. I don't do the black like charcoal ones anymore. Those don't help. They don't help me. Maybe if you have oily skin, non-sensitive, but my skin's just too sensitive and I don't want it to affect. I just peel it off and it just, my face is just red. It doesn't feel good. It just doesn't work. Okay. What else about personal hygiene? Oh, personal hygiene. Let me know if you guys want me to do more personal hygiene videos because I'd love to. I'm gonna talk about perfume. Let me go grab my favorite perfume. I've been using this one. This is called Pink Vanilla Kiss Body Fantasies. It's like the cotton candy. I love the cotton candy scent. This is like a 10-year-old body scent. I love this so much. It smells so good. They basically ran out of this kind of a spray, like cotton candy smelling. So I'm gonna have to buy them off of Amazon from now on. It's Victoria's Secret Tropic Splash. I just got it like a month ago. It smells so like, this is one of my most like perfume smelling perfumes. I normally just get like fruity smelling. Like yeah, no matter what I do, I just make sure I have a perfume in my bag wherever I'm going and I spray it. Honestly, it just depends on the day, how I'm feeling, maybe once every like 2 hours, just like, I don't know where my Pure Seduction went. I'll pop up a picture, Pure Seduction by Victoria's Secret, my favorite perfume hands down. Also, I put this in my purse. This is called Victoria's Secret. This is their Bombshell Seduction perfume. And it's a rollerball. I put this right behind my ears, okay? If anyone gets near you, smells you, like on my neck. And I also heard you can like put it on top of your head, like on your scalp or something, like if they hug you, what? I also have this perfume from Scentbird from a couple videos ago. I mean, if you follow me. So it's basically Scentbird. It's not, this isn't sponsored. My other one video was, but they do high-end perfumes on the low. And this is called Kat Von D Saint. It smells like something in here. Smells like Bath & Body Works. So another one of my favorites is Victoria's Secret Jungle Lily. Victoria's Secret perfumes are hands down just amazing body washes. Body washes? I know these aren't perfumes. Body sprays. Don't kill me in the comments. Okay, I get it. This one smells good. Smells like the forest. My last body, my skincare tip is water. I really recommend actually getting a Hydro Flask because especially if you buy it yourself, they're expensive and they make you, it makes you not want to lose it. It makes you actually want to bring it to places and have the water. Because it's a Hydro Flask, okay? Society. Drinking water, sometimes it's really bad and I don't even drink water in a day. But having a Hydro Flask has really helped me for that. Okay, this is probably going to be a long-ass video. I know it's really weird that I filmed myself showering and da-da-da, but personal hygiene is so important, especially like if you look cute every day, if you do the best you can for your outfit, you smell good, you use lotion, you look good, you wash yourself properly. If you're not doing one of those things, especially like if you're trying to get into a relationship, you need to make sure that you smell good, you brush your teeth, all that, because nobody wants to be with a girl that doesn't take care of themselves. Period. Okay. After my shower, I brush my teeth. I use this Crest whitening scope, whatever. Whitening toothpaste, it's great. And I use this Oral-B toothbrush that is... It's electric. Woogie, woogie, woogie. Never had an electric toothbrush before, and this is awesome, amazing. Awesome, amazing, cool, fun, fresh. Because sometimes in the morning, I'm literally so lazy, and I don't want to be like... Ugh. So literally, this does the work for me. I just have to like, you know... for like 2 minutes. So I'm gonna brush my teeth right now, actually. I to you guys in my next video. Hopefully this was helpful. I mean, sometimes your parents don't even teach you these kinds of things. So I'm trying to be your big sister, okay? Help a girl out. So this is me signing off. You see like how glowy my skin is? Okay. Peace out. H-Town.